You are listening to WIXQ, Millersville, Pennsylvania, 91.7 FM, The Ville.
Hi, I'm Matt Kenseth. You don't have to be a race car driver to know that life can be full of drama. Some of it you can't control, like mechanical issues, high winds, and rain delays. But there's some drama you can skip.
Skip the drama that comes with not having your high school diploma or equivalency. Find free adult education classes near you and finish your diploma. Visit finishyourdiploma.org. That's finishyourdiploma.org.
You just need to take that first step and find free classes near you and leave the drama for the racetrack.
Brought to you by the Dollar General Literacy Foundation and the Ed Council.
Gentlemen, tune in to What is Savage every Sunday from 7 a.m. to 10 a.m. with your host, Tiger Sprout. Only here on WIXQ 91.7 FM, The Ville.
WIXQ is owned by Millersville University and operated by the students as an extracurricular activity. The opinions expressed on air are those of the DJs and do not reflect the views of WIXQ or its staff. As always, keep it locked to your number one music source, WIXQ 91.7 FM, The Ville.
Painted red, the stripe was white, it was 18 feet and about a stern line. Secondhand from a dealer in Atlanta, I rode up with Daddy when he went there to get her. Put on a shine, put on a motor, built out of love, made for water. Ran her for years till her transom got rotten. A piece of my childhood will never be forgotten. It was just an old plywood boat, the 75 Johnson with electric choke. A young boy, two hands on the wheel. I can't replace the way it made me feel. And I would turn her sharp knife, make it wine, he'd say. You can't beat the way an old wood boat rides. Just a little lake across the Alabama line, but I was king of the ocean when Daddy let me drive. Just an old half-ton short bed Ford my uncle bought new in 64. Daddy got it right, cause the engine was smoking. Couple of burnt valves and he had it going. He'd let me drive her, and we'd haul off a load down a dirt strip where we'd dump trash off a thick pin road. I'd sit up in the seat and stretch my feet out to the pedals, smiling like a hero that just received his medal. It was just an old hand-me-down Ford with three-speed on the column and a dent in the door. A young boy, two hands on the wheel. I can't replace the way it made me feel. And I would press that clutch and I'd keep it right. He'd say, a little slower, son, you're doing just fine. Just a dirt road with trash on each side, but I was merry, oh, and ready when Daddy let me drive. I'm grown up now, three daughters of my own. I let them drive my old Jeep across the pasture at our home. Maybe one day they'll reach back in their file and pull out that old memory and think of me and smile and say, it's just an old worn out Jeep, rusty old floorboards, hot on my feet. A young girl, two hands on the wheel. I can't replace the way it made me feel. And he'd say, turn it left and steer it right. Straighten up, girl, now you're doing just fine. Just a little valley by the river where we'd ride, but I was high on a mountain when Daddy let me drive. Just an old plywood boat with a 75 Johnson with electric choke.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are back on the air. I'm Tiger Sprout. You're listening to What a Savage. Frank is still laying on the couch. Actually, just sat up now. So congratulations, Frank, for sitting on up on the couch. Frank is still here. Frank is doing his training part of the show. He did 20 minutes today. He will do 40 minutes next week. The following week, he will do an hour. He will take the test, and I'm hoping he passes. He thinks he's going to pass, right?
Probably.
All right. He thinks he's going to pass. I think he's going to pass, and it's just going to be a great time because Frank is then going to be a co-host for the show because I would like to have a co-host, but I'd like to have someone that I actually know because I don't want to have some random stranger come in. I have to get to know him and everything like that because I don't want to make friends. So here we are back to the show. I'm going to talk a little bit of football because it is the best sport you could ever think about in the whole entire world. So with that being said, let me first give a disclaimer that when I do my score predictions, think the exact opposite because the last 2 weeks, and I have a couple people who can attest for that, who's been listening on a constant basis. Anytime I've predicted a game, it's been the exact opposite for every game these past 2 weeks. So anything I say, take it with a grain of a pinch of salt. How do you say it? Grain of salt? You know, take it with no structure behind it. Like, don't quote me on it because I'm probably just going to be wrong anyway. I think what's going to happen, and for some reason, every single one's wrong. So top headlines going on in the National Football League. The 49ers have released Navarro Bowman, their middle linebacker, after Reuben Foster has been promoted to the starting linebacker spot for him. There was actually a trade set for him to go to the New Orleans Saints, but it fell out, so it never happened. Pittsburgh Steelers, you know who you are. Sign Navarro Bowman because it just helps with the black and gold. So there's a light at the end of the tunnel, and Navarro Bowman is going to be blocking it. Along with that, the Carolina Panthers' Luke Kuechly has cleared protocol for his third concussion within his NFL career. Coming from previous experiences with concussions, they are nothing to mess with. Frank, have you ever had a concussion before?
No.
Never had a concussion?
Yep, I'm lucky.
Day in your life?
No, because I don't play football, and I've never
We only do it for fun, basically.
Okay, so yeah. You've never had a head injury before?
Nope, I'm very lucky.
All right.
Hospital either.
Okay, well, I've been to the hospital many times, but some reasons a little different from others, but I've had a concussion before, and it's not fun.
No.
No. So, along with that, we have the Miami Dolphins head coach, or not head coach, sorry about that, offensive line coach, Forrester enters rehab because he was caught smoking a substance that was white powder. And if you're caught, you're done. Plain and simple. So he is going to be serving his time. He has resigned, should have been fired, but we'll be on different terms on that. That's okay. I don't work for the NFL. Along with that, Packers running back Ty Montgomery will be playing today, and that's good for my fantasy team because he is on my team. But if he gets injured, you know he's going to be sitting there on the free agent pool as I pick up someone else. All right, ladies and gentlemen, and the most awesome part of the day where I give my score predictions and they're most likely going to be wrong. So here we go as Frank laughs over there. First game I have up here is the Atlanta Falcons taking on the Miami Dolphins. It'll be at the Mercedes-Benz Stadium in Atlanta, Georgia. Atlanta's a very nice place, and I think that Matt Ryan has what it takes to keep Atlanta rolling with the wins. And Atlanta is just going to run all over the Miami Dolphins because Jay Cutler is Jay Cutler, and Jay Cutler is their quarterback. And Jay Cutler is trash, plain and simple. Doesn't matter what anybody says, he will always be trash, and he's always been trash. So along with that, we have the Minnesota Vikings taking on the Green Bay Packers. Green Bay Packers will be traveling to Minneapolis, Minnesota to take on those Vikings. Who is quarterback today? No one really knows. I think it's going to be Case Keenum because Sam Bradford, with his previous knee history injuries, I don't know if he's ready to come back onto the field yet because they had a very close game in Chicago against the Chicago Bears, and I thought they had what it took to win the game, but it just never worked out that way, and Case Keenum really lit him up. So I'm giving it to the Packers because consistency, Aaron Rodgers, and he's an MVP candidate for this year. The Detroit Lions taking on the New Orleans Saints. The New Orleans Saints are just not the New Orleans Saints of the Super Bowl era that they've had before. And Drew Brees is just getting older. It's time to move on. I just don't see it. Adrian Peterson has been traded to the Arizona Cardinals. Good for them because, as I have constantly said over the past couple weeks, Adrian Peterson was such a bad decision for a pass-heavy offense. I cannot express my disappointment in that team. And my friend Bug has heard me complain many times about this because he's a New Orleans Saints fan. We work at the Skating Castle together. And anytime I pass by him, I'm saying, hey, I'm doing more rushing yards than Adrian Peterson has ever done his whole New Orleans Saints career. So that is out to you, Bug. We have the New England Patriots taking on the New York Jets today. The Patriots, you know, they're the Patriots. They're just going to take down the Jets. The Jets have Josh McCown. Josh McCown is a reliable backup. He's not a starter. Look what he did in Cleveland. That helicopter dive, concussion, out for the game. Johnny Manziel came in. He's just not consistent. So I'm giving it to the Patriots, giving it to Tom Brady. I'm giving it to an MVP candidate right there. New game going on here. We have the San Francisco 49ers taking on the Washington Redskins in FedEx Field in Landover, Maryland. You know, Frank, I have considered looking into the Washington Redskins as a potential employer one day because just because of the history that they've had for that team. And, you know, right there in the heart of Washington, D.C., it's easy to commute there. So look out because I may be working for the Washington Redskins someday, and I would love to. Come on. It's the nation's, like, capital. You can commute. You don't have to pay the taxes to live there. And they're always open to hiring people, especially, like, internships. I'm looking into it. I just got to find out if I'm really willing to travel to Washington, D.C. every day. What do you think about that?
I mean, you say you always want to work for any, like, type of, like, football, like, thing. I mean, I could see you doing it, but I don't know. I mean, not to be a downer or anything, but, I mean, sorry, that's just my opinion.
You are a downer.
I know.
So, I'm giving it to the Redskins today. Consistency, Kirk Cousins. As I see this funny video going on Facebook. It's a guy who does a live commentary for the games after every one. And there is some foul language in it, but it's very funny. And for anyone who have seen the videos, and there are a couple out there because I've shared it with a couple people, I'm giving it to Kurt family members today, and he's just going to take down the 0-5 49ers because Brian Hoyer is not the answer for the 49ers quarterback solution, and they will be drafting one coming this upcoming NFL draft going on in April. Let's bring it back to Philly. That's right. Philadelphia, let's host that NFL draft once again. So we have the Baltimore Ravens taking on the Chicago Bears. Mitch Trubisky has really turned that Bears team around, and I'm giving it to the Bears over the Ravens because Joe Flacco, just like I've always felt, trash. He's not anything special. He's not elite. He got that bogus contract after winning that Super Bowl, and after that, gone downhill. So the defense is the only thing they've got going for them in Baltimore. The Bears, I'm giving it to them, and Mitch Trubisky. This is a matchup I've always dreamed about doing in Madden, but in real life, it's really not a good one on paper. We have the Cleveland Browns taking on the Houston Texans. I'm in a Madden fantasy type of like football thing with my buddy Sean, and I'm actually the Cleveland Browns. And my goal was to take them to the Super Bowl. I'm struggling as I get there because I've gone through maybe 5 quarterbacks thus far because they've all been getting injured, or I've been paying too much for them, so I just drop them right away. So I'm having a little more success than the actual Cleveland Browns are doing, but I just don't see them getting their first win today. They're going to go 0-6. Houston Texans, Deshaun Watson is really the answer for them right there. Tom Savage, I thought, had a chance, but that's bias for me from the University of Pittsburgh, and he is not going to be anything going for them anytime soon. I could see him going as a free agent coming this upcoming offseason. But Deshaun Watson is just going to lead them to a 3-3 record as they get the victory once again because that defense is going to be holding Cleveland down all game long. They're in NRG Stadium there in Houston, Texas. So we have the Tampa Bay Buccaneers taking on the Arizona Cardinals. I believe Adrian Peterson will be making his debut today, but I'm unsure if he's had enough time to, you know, get to know that playbook. But I'm still giving it to the Buccaneers because Jameis Winston is really the prodigal son for Tampa Bay. DeSean Jackson, Mike Evans, who is on my fantasy team, so is Jameis Winston, because if they're on my fantasy team, they're going to do amazing. Because if you look at my fantasy record, I'm amazing. So why would I draft trash players? You know what I mean, Frank? All right, you can't relate.
Sorry, I can't relate.
All right, so yeah. I'm giving it to the Bucs. The Arizona Cardinals have just nothing really special going for them. I've expected a better outcome for them thus far, and unless they prove me wrong, I don't see it happening anytime soon. This is actually a good game. Surprisingly a good game, I'll say. The Los Angeles Rams going on against the Jacksonville Jaguars. Yes, Blake Bortles hasn't been having the best game. Sorry as I tried to talk too fast and I'm thinking. But Leonard Fournette has really been the X factor for Jacksonville, running all over Pittsburgh last week, getting that surprise win. And these are two up-and-coming teams. If Jacksonville gets a new quarterback, this is an upcoming team right here itself. I believe that's all they're missing. They have a great defense. So does the Rams. They just got to work on keeping the ball out of the end zone, but they're, you know, stopping the ball, passing and run-wise, they're doing a pretty good job. So 3-2 teams going on at it.
But I'm giving it to the Rams because they are more of a complete team than Jacksonville Jaguars are. Unless Leonard Fournette goes on a run-happy trail game, everything like that, this is going to the Jaguars because he has just been dominant. And he's a future rookie of the year right there for the stats he's been putting up. This is the game I'm really not excited about because I'm getting a little nervous about it. It's Pittsburgh Steelers taking on the Kansas City Chiefs. The Kansas City Chiefs are 5-0, and Alex Smith is their quarterback. After they drafted Patrick Mahomes, Alex Smith has been on a roll because he knows any mistake he makes, he's losing his job. Who wants to lose their job? Frank, would you ever want to lose a job?
No.
So that's what I'm saying. Why would you want to lose your job? Alex Smith has been putting up numbers. He's been an MVP candidate himself, but because of names like Tom Brady and Aaron Rodgers, I know he's going to get snubbed out. They should put me in there as voting because I'm more fair and more unbiased than anyone else in the league because they're trying to make some dollar bills. I'm trying to bring some fans back to watching football once again. So Kareem Hunt is also going to be a factor on that team, and Tyreek Hill, who's on my fantasy team. So, you know, Kansas City Chiefs are going to be lighting up the Pittsburgh Steelers unless they stop the pass and the run, because the Steelers need to prove something if they want to stay atop of the AFC North because they have been inconsistent. Ben Roethlisberger, this is going out to you. It's time to change the game. It's time to play the game, as Triple H would say. So get the ball to Le'Veon Bell a little bit more. Let him do what he does and let him score some touchdowns because this is going to be Le'Veon Bell's team one day because soon it's going to be time for Big Ben to move on out and time to bring another quarterback in. I don't think Josh Dobbs is the answer. I think they should sign me up as quarterback. Because I could pull a Michael Vick. I'm pretty fast. Frank, have you ever seen me run before?
No, and you're not that fast. Sorry.
How are you going to say that if you've never seen me run before?
I don't know.
All right, so other people have seen me run before, and I can attest that I'm pretty fast, and they can attest for me too. I could pull a Michael Vick. I don't have to run, or I don't have to pass. I could just run the whole game, and I'd be just fine. I'm short, so it's not like they'll see me behind the offensive line anyway. I could probably sneak right through and get a couple shuffle plays in to Le'Veon Bell, and you know, I could change Pittsburgh Steelers offense any day of the week because I'll be running for my life. Because I know if I'm going down, I'm getting hurt. So Pittsburgh, call me up. I'm ready to play. I'll take the base minimum for playing. I don't care what it is.
But you gotta be careful though.
Oh, I'm running. I'm just running away from my life. So we have the Los Angeles Chargers taking on the Oakland Raiders, and I believe Derek Carr is back for this game. The Raiders, I'm giving it to them because consistency, especially Derek Carr's playing. Chargers, it's time to move away from Los Angeles. That was such a bad idea. I knew it, but it doesn't matter what the fans say. It doesn't matter what anybody says because you can do whatever you want. Well, watch your ratings drop. Watch your money drop. And, Frank, I think we should buy the Los Angeles Chargers someday. They may be worth something very soon, close to our price range, because of how downhill they're going. We can own a football team. And I'll be in charge. You could just...
I'll just watch.
And yeah, just watch. We'll combine together and then I'll buy your shares out. You'll have your money back plus a little more. And that's our life.
Sounds a good deal.
All right, here we go. So the Denver Broncos taking on the New York Giants tonight. Sunday Night Football. I'm giving this to Trevor Siemian and the Denver Broncos. Eli Manning, it's time to retire. It's time to leave the New York Giants because your career is just going downhill. Monday Night Football, we have the Indianapolis Colts taking on the Tennessee Titans there in Nashville, Tennessee. Frank, have you ever been to Tennessee before?
Nope.
I'd like to go to Tennessee someday. I think I would fit in very well.
Yeah. I know you'd like to go anywhere in the South, I think.
All right. See, yeah. Frank knows me really well with the South.
I do, yeah. You love it.
I'd love to move down South one day because the cost of living is pretty cheap. There's actually a website, bankrate.com. They have like a cost of living index. Closest to us would be Philly. But if you put in Philly, as into where you're from, and you put into where you want to go, it shows you the cost of living with what salary you think you'd be making someday. So if you start out like, I don't know, for us, base salary coming out of school, maybe about, what, $35,000,
$40,000? Yeah, but I thought it was a little bit higher, like living in the South, really?
Down South, no, it's cheaper. Because things move a little slower down South.
Who knew?
When you're closer to New York and you're closer to California, things are getting a little pricey.
Oh, yeah.
But when you move down South, things are getting pretty cheap.
True.
So if you put in like Philly for us, because that's closest to us, and you put about $35,000, $40,000 as base salary for us coming out of school, and they give you an estimate of cost of living down there, and they're about $5,000 to $10,000 lower. So you know what salary to aim for if you're moving, and you know you won't be at that cost of living. You'll be making a little more.
Yeah.
Then you can do fun stuff like go to Sky Zone.
Exactly.
Open up a Sky Zone down there. Trent, you heard us. We're opening up a Sky Zone down south. Come and join us.
Get ready.
All right. So, ladies and gentlemen, let us get to these 20-minute commercial breaks. And that's it for football. That's all I got. And when we come back, we'll do a little bit more music. Frank, if you want to talk some more, we'll put you on the air a little more. That's fine with me.
Yeah, we'll see. Yeah.
I keep forgetting that the mic's already on right now. So
yeah,
you could have said anything you wanted to, and I wouldn't have known.
Yeah, but it's your show. I mean, I'd let you...
It's going to be our show, Frank. One day it's going
to
be our show.
I know, but for now, it's your show. I mean, it's up to you.
So that is it from us about football. Frank, thank you for giving a little spiel on football, even though you don't know much about it. But
I don't know much, but I try.
That's all that matters. As long as you try.
That's right.
Try hard. Do your best. Mm-hmm. As you would tell us when
Believe in yourself.
Yes. As you would tell us when we played poker down at the beach.
And ping pong. Yes. Believe in yourself. And you will do good things.
Even though you've lost your money, and I got money, you would always tell me, believe in yourself.
That's right.
So thank you.
Yes.
Thank you for making me money down at the beach.
Mm-hmm.
So here we go, ladies and gentlemen, with some commercials, and we'll be back on the air. I am Tiger Sprout, that is Andrew Frank, and you are listening to What a Savage here on WIXQ 91.7 FM, The Bill.
Angry Young and Poor is an independently owned record and clothing store that has been selling everything punk rock since 1995. They have an extensive collection of new and vintage vinyl records, punk and metal t-shirts, leather jackets, and Doc Martens. Angry Young and Poor is located on 356 West Orange Street in Lancaster. They are open from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. every day except Wednesday and Sunday. More information can be found on their website, angryyoungandpoor.com, or by calling 717-397-6116.
On guard, Millersville. This is Jacob from the Fencing Guild with an important reminder to stick 'em with the pointy end. If you are looking for a fun and unique sport to play, or just want to meet new people, then fencing is the sport for you. All are welcome and no experience is necessary. Come out to Brooks Gym every Wednesday 7 to 9 p.m. and Fridays 6 to 10 p.m. for some fencing fun. Hope to see you there.
Attention men, under the age of 35. You know what really impresses the ladies? When a guy has a few drinks and later gets pulled over for buzz driving. That could cost you around $10,000 in fines, legal fees, and increased insurance rates. There goes let's grab dinner and a movie. Oh, I know. You drive more carefully when you're buzzed. You've proven that hundreds of times. A woman admires that kind of confidence. And you've practiced how to speak if a cop does pull you over. Slowly, clearly, and politely, like, good evening, officer. A woman admires that kind of foresight. And what woman doesn't find it adorable that you call it buzzed even though the law calls it drunk? You could kiss $10,000 goodbye, along with any chance of having a girlfriend. Because nothing says, I'm a catch, more than a guy who lives in his parents' basement and calls it my place.
Buzzed, busted, and broke. Because buzz driving is drunk driving. A message from the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
Lose you, and I don't know where I'm. crazy about a shirtless man.
Again, welcome to the land of fame, excess. Am I gonna fit in? Jumped in the cab, here I am for the first time. Look to my right and I see the Hollywood sign. This is all so crazy, everybody seems so famous. My tummy's turning and I'm feeling kinda homesick. Too much pressure and I'm nervous. That's when the taxi man turned on the radio and the Jay-Z song was on. And the Jay-Z song was on. And the Jay-Z in my taxi cab, everybody's looking at me now. Like, who's that chick that's rocking kicks? She gotta be from out of town. So hard with my girls not around me. It's definitely not a Nashville party. Cause all I see is the lit up. I guess I never got the memo. My tummy's turning and I'm feeling kinda homesick. Too much pressure and I'm nervous. That's when the DJ drummed my favorite tune.
surprised. Not everything lasts. I've broken my heart so many times I stopped keeping track. Talk myself in, I talk myself out. I get all worked up, then I let myself down. I tried so very hard not to lose it. I came up with a million excuses. I thought of every possibility. And I know someday that it'll all turn out. You'll make me work so we can work to work it out. And I promise you, kid, that I'll get so much more than I get. I just haven't met you yet. I might have to wait, I'll never give up. I guess it's half timing and the other half's luck. Wherever you are, whenever it's right, you'll come out of nowhere and into my life. And I know that we can be so amazing. And baby, your love is gonna change me. And now I can see every possibility. Somehow I know that it'll all turn out. You'll make me work so we can work to work it out. And I promise you, kid, I'll give so much more than I get. I just haven't met you yet. They say all's fair in love and war. But I won't need to fight it. Someday I know it'll all turn out. And I'll work to work it out. Promise you, kid, I'll give more than I get. Than I get, than I get, than I get. Oh, you know it'll all turn out. And you'll make me work so we can work to work it out. And I promise you, kid, to give so much more than I get. Just haven't met you yet. I just haven't met you yet. Oh, I promise you, kid, to give so much more than I get. I just haven't met you yet. Haven't met you yet.
On guard, Millersville. This is Jacob from the Fencing Guild with an important reminder to stick 'em with the pointy end. If you are looking for a fun and unique sport to play, or just want to meet new people, then fencing is the sport for you. All are welcome and no experience is necessary. Come out to Brooks Gym every Wednesday, 7 to 9 p.m., and Fridays, 6 to 10 p.m. for some fencing fun. Hope to see you there.
Arbaton.
In 2013, Millersville University student Thomas Chistiak established a t-shirt company and named it Arbaton. Today, Arbaton offers a variety of t-shirt designs, including their classic series, their flagship product line. Arbaton ships to all 50 states and internationally as well. They can be reached on their website, arbitonstore.com, or at 484-999-0121. Arbaton, strive for the upper echelon.
Ask not what your WIXQ can do for you.
ask, what can you do for your WIXQ?
So listen to WIXQ 91.7 The Ville, your number one music source.
All right, we're back on the air because Frank has been consistent about having the conversation about something and keep asking what we want to talk about, but keep saying, I don't know.
Because I'm indecisive.
Yeah, that's my problem. You are. Yeah, I know that's your problem.
Yeah, I have lots of problems.
Like, yeah, I'm not even going to get into that. So, you know, I got to say, Frank, you have been like a bit of motivation for me in school because you're such a downer. That, like, anytime I try to do something good in school, you're always like, well, you're not going to do good, blah, blah, blah. But then I turn out to do good anyway. You know? You know what I'm talking about, right?
No.
No?
Not at all.
All right, I'll give an example. So, comm classes, for example. I don't study for them. Tests.
Yeah, I know you don't.
Because they're common sense to me.
Mm-hmm.
And what are my grades, Frank?
I don't know. You tell them.
I'm doing pretty good.
Yeah.
Last test we took, passed. B+. So, anytime Frank always puts me down, I always try to outdo him because I need to prove him wrong. Because Frank and I have a little competition going on where, like, he tries to one-up me on everything, but it never happens. Does it, Frank?
Yeah.
Not yet.
Really. Not yet. It will happen.
I'm waiting for the day it will happen. I'm giving you hope. Yep, I know one day it's going to happen.
You'll see. Just
but
wait.
It hasn't happened yet. Mm. So, Frank and I always try to one-up each other on something, but it's been going to my advantage thus far. And Frank has really been keeping me going through school because that's source of motivation.
Yeah.
Whether you know it or not.
Right.
So, I don't know, Frank. How's school going for you?
It's going okay. I mean, some of my classes are a little bit hard, but I mean, I'm just hanging in there. Just doing my best to stay on top of my assignments.
We actually have registration going on soon for classes for next semester. And
yeah.
I have mine all planned out. Just got to get the tap number to put in the computer. And because of my class standing, I could do it sooner to right away than other people. And
including me.
Yep, including you. And I actually helped Frank out with choosing some classes.
Yep, he did.
I'm trying to look out for Frank, too. I'm trying to get him done with school sooner than possible.
Mm-hmm.
So you're welcome.
Yep, thank you.
Because somebody has to look out for people.
That's right. I mean,
I look out for you. And
I mean, like I tell you, you're like the dad, and I'm like, I don't know what I am to you, but
you're like a tough love motivational support, I'll say.
I'll take that.
Because you're always trying to put me down.
No, it doesn't work. No, I don't put you down. I just try to make you, I don't know. I mean, I just want to try to make myself feel better than you sometimes. But
yeah,
I don't try to put you down, though. Not intentionally. I just want to make myself feel important, too.
I know, because we joke about stuff all the time.
Yeah.
Sometimes I'm sorry that we joke about stuff, but
No, don't be sorry.
It's tough love.
Yeah, it is tough love, yeah.
Actually, I wanted to bring this up, Frank, because there's actually an event going on Thursday, October 26th. It's happening at 9:30. I have class 6 to 9 on Thursdays, but I'm planning on going to this event, making sure that, you know, I'm free, no schoolwork, nothing big going on, because I'm trying to knock it all out soon so that I have less to worry about. And it's at the American Legion. So I go there every once in a while. But they're having a college night thing going on the 26th. It's their Halloween edition. It's kind of like a party going on. So $5 at the door, but it's free with a college ID. So bring your college ID. You get in for free. Drinks are there. There's a costume contest. Sorry about that. It's a $100 prize for the best costume. So you may see me going in there as Batman because,
oh, wow,
you know, $100
yeah,
is on the line.
I can see that.
I will do anything for $100.
You would, yeah.
So I will go in as Batman just to get $100 and walk out. I will wear that suit the rest of the time. I will even dance in that suit with the mask on and everything. So, October 26th, mark your calendar because American Legion, they're having that event. So free with college ID, make sure you bring that because if not, $5 at the door. So it's fun time. It's fun for college people to get together and, you know, spreading the word out there because I'll be there, so I'd like to have other people be there too.
Yeah.
Get to know me, the DJ, and as much as sometimes I don't like to make friends, but I'll make friends.
Yeah.
I know Frank likes to make friends every once in a while.
Yeah, I try.
Yeah. So you should consider going.
Yeah. You said October 26th, right?
Yeah, it's a Thursday.
And what time is it again?
9:30.
9:30.
Yes. And I don't have classes Friday. I know you don't have classes Friday.
Correct.
So you should consider going.
Yeah. And
it's fun time.
It's after the gym. So, I mean, that'd be perfect.
All right. So there we go. Yeah. So don't forget, October 26th, look on going.
You just have to remind me. And
I will.
I mean, I may not wear a costume, but I mean.
I'll talk about it next week, too.
Yeah.
So it's 9:46. We've got about 14 minutes left in the show. Frank, is there anything left you want to talk about? Because if not, we're just going
to
play music.
I mean, it's up to you. If you've got anything to ask me, I mean, go ahead.
I don't know. I can't think of anything.
Me neither.
All right, then. So we're going to get back to the music. Frank, thank you for coming out and being on the show again, because your 20 minutes of fame is all over, but next week you'll have 40 minutes.
That's right. Next week I'll be on for about 40 minutes, and you'll hear a lot of good music, so get ready. I'm coming for
– Yeah.
I'm coming.
I've heard some of that music, and it's not bad.
It's not bad. I mean, I think it's good music. I mean, I try to stick with, like, what's new and everything. I do some old school, too, but, I mean, mostly new stuff, but –
Sometimes I wish we had a camera in this studio just to, like, have people notice that you're doing, like, dances and
I don't
gym stuff in here.
I don't dance. Or
yes,
I just,
you do.
I
you're
just,
like in here going, attack,
movement.
Attack.
I just see little movements because I don't know. I'm just used to it.
Yeah, and when you're not laying on the couch, sitting on the couch, or sitting in the chair over there by the mic, you are doing some gym.
Well, I mean, when you're here for 3 hours, I mean, it does get a little tedious just sitting around. So, I mean, you got to have some energy just to, you know, be able to, you know, like, lay in the mood a bit and just to get those energy up. I mean, it's you got to do it. You got to do what you got to do to get through the 3 hours.
You can catch Frank at Universal Gym because he's always there.
That's right.
And anytime I try to, like, ask him, hey, when are you coming into class? Or when are you coming into school and we can hang out before class? No, he's at the gym.
Because that's right.
Gym's more important because gym is life, isn't it, Frank?
I would say it's more important, but, I mean, it is a big thing in my life.
All right,
that I'll be honest about.
So Frank will be on next week. Don't forget to tune in for him. And for everyone out there listening, if you missed anything of the show, you can listen to all 3 hours of the show, What a Savage, on my YouTube page. Just search Tiger Sprout. All 3 hours are there. The music is included. No copyrights from me because I don't own any. Well, no copyrights from me because I don't own anything. I put that out there, disclaimer. And all the show is going to be there, so you just have to sift through if you just want to hear the talking parts. If you want to hear some music, some, like, replays of the show, it's all there. Because I don't want to take time just to edit out the music, because sometimes people want to relive the show.
Yeah.
Or if they miss the show, they just want to live in that moment as if they heard the show.
Mm-hmm.
I know one day I'd like to listen to the shows again, because one day I'm just not going to be doing this anymore.
Right.
So, who knows? Who knows? I may do radio someday. Right job market?
Yeah, maybe, yeah.
Right source of money?
I could definitely see you doing that maybe as a potential career.
It's going to have to be the right price because I won't do it for nothing.
Yeah.
Because I got to be making money too. It's all about the ching-ching, right?
Right.
Because you got to have bling-bling.
That's right.
All right. So let's get back to the music. That is it for us on What is Savage. We got 11 minutes actually now because it just changed. 11 minutes left in the show. And you have been listening to What is Savage. I'm Tiger Sprout. That's Andrew Frank. And we'll see you next week here, back here, and better than we will ever be.
Mm-hmm.
Big fight, so I drove around till I saw the neon lights of a corner bar, and it just seemed right, so I pulled up. Not a soul around but the old barkeep down at the end looking half asleep, but he walked up and said, what'll it be? I said, the good stuff. He didn't reach around for the whiskey, he didn't pour me a beer. Blue eyes kind of went misty. He said, you can't find that here. Cause it's the first long kiss on a second date. Mama's all worried when you get home late. Dropping the ring in the spaghetti plate. Cause your hands are shaking so much. And it's the way that she looks with her eyes and her hair. Eating burnt suppers the whole first year. And asking for seconds to keep her from tears. Yeah, man, that's the good stuff. He grabbed a carton of milk and he poured a glass. And I smiled and said, I'll have some of that. We sat there and talked as an hour passed, like old friends. I saw a black and white picture and it caught my stare. It was a pretty girl with bouffant hair. He said, that's my bummer, taken about a year after we wed. He said, I spent 5 years in the bottle when the cancer took her from me. But I've been sober 3 years now, cause the one thing stronger than the whiskey was the sight of her holding our baby girl. The way she adored that string of pearls I gave her the day that our youngest boy earned. Married his high school love. And it's a new t-shirt saying I'm a grandpa. Been right there as our time got small. And holding her hand when the good Lord called her up. Yeah, man, that's the good stuff. He said, when you start to cry when she says I'm sorry, say so am I. And look into those eyes so deep in love and drank it up. Cause that's the good stuff. That's the good stuff.
And ladies and gentlemen, that was the show today. You have been listening to What is Savage. My name is Tiger Sprout. Andrew Frank was here on the air. Frank, you want to say a final goodbye?
Sure. I mean, I just want to say once again, thank you for having me on. I mean, it's a lot of fun right now. I mean, I'm still learning a lot here. So in the next couple of weeks, it's definitely going to get a lot better. And we're going to have a lot of good conversations and I'm going to give you a lot of good topics to talk about. So, I mean, get ready.
Frank is really like a dad figure. He's always looking out for people. So if you check out his Facebook picture, too, is a picture of him and Trenton Clements. Oh. And he has a really good dad pose going on. So Frank is actually a bachelor. So any ladies out there, Frank is single. Yeah. So who knows? Frank says he's going to be a bachelor for the rest of his life. But
oh, I don't know about that.
Somebody could probably change his status. Am I right?
I don't know.
Person comes along. Give him a chance.
I'll give him a chance, but I don't know.
All right. So that was Andrew Frank, everyone. He will be back here next week for 40 minutes. So you've been listening to What is Savage, and we're going to go into commercials, and we have Dr. Greg coming on top of the hour. So thank you for tuning in, everyone.
You are listening to WIXQ, Millersville, Pennsylvania, 91.7 FM, The Ville.